Little late Sunday night recording. Figured I'd pop on here and just let everyone know that, yes, after hours upon hours of waiting, we finally have a kickoff time for OU Baylor. It's getting a little scary for a while, but whatever the hang-up was, ACC football kickoff times were popping up, and then all of a sudden Big 12 games were popping up. So good news there. I didn't want to have to come on here and talk about more scenarios if games get canceled. Will the Big 12 championship happen? Because we already took care of business. actually, I should say Baylor did us a solid last night by beating K-State. And we will do them a solid by hopefully whooping them by 4 touchdowns. No thanks, Baylor, but business is business. So, want to talk about this because it's been on my mind. And I like to talk about the sport overall, not just my team. And I'm going to get this out of the way right now. You're looking at the title of the video and you're saying to yourself, he's in it. He's making these arguments for his team. All this, absolutely true. I am totally making this video because I have my own agenda. I want Oklahoma to somehow, even with 2 losses, still get to the playoff. And yeah, I'm just being upfront about it because I do believe there's a path. Now, my path beforehand involved Ohio State being in the playoff because before the potential of Ohio State not even making the Big Ten championship or having their season cut short, my ideal scenario was Alabama, Ohio State, Notre Dame winning out and opening up that 4th spot. So Clemson would get knocked off a second time. Cincinnati maybe or maybe not lose to Tulsa once or twice. Who knows? I still think a 2-loss Oklahoma team has a puncher's chance to get in over undefeated Cincinnati. Power 5 bias, call it all you want. But so, I just want to get that out of the way right now. I have no ill will towards Ohio State. I think they're getting screwed out of this whole deal because they wanted to play football all year. And the Big Ten was the one twiddling their thumbs and not getting their shit together. Because it's the Big Ten. And the only reason the Big Ten came back, and this involves Pac-12 too, because there's like a handful of people out there who still think like a 3-0 USC is going to sneak into this thing, which is ridiculous. But the Big Ten screwed themselves because they took too long. And this is my argument from a conference standpoint. If it wasn't for the Big 12, there would be no college football season. Now, does that mean the Big 12 or the Big 12 conference champion is owed a playoff spot? No, not necessarily. What I'm saying is, though, when we were down to the nitty-gritty in August, or whether it was going to go one way or another, the SEC and the ACC were all on board. It came down to whether who was going to convince the Big 12. If they could convince the Big 12 to say, yes, we're going to play football. Because the Big 10 said, we're not playing football. Sent shockwaves throughout the sports world. The Pac-12, because their bosom buddies with the Rose Bowl pals, immediately followed suit. So it was like it was down to the 3 conferences who really, really cared about playing football this year. And they played multiple games. Have games been canceled in all 3 conferences or moved or shuffled around? Yes. But it appears, for the most part, that the SEC, the ACC, and the Big 12, fingers crossed, will crown a champion in their conference through conference championship games. So, the Big 10, who came back late in the game, late October, mind you, with very strict rules and regulations, said, okay, if you don't win or play a certain amount of games and the rest of the games don't come on down, then you won't be even eligible for the conference title game. And right now, Ohio State is in a dangerous situation where if they don't play Michigan State and Michigan, they probably need to play both. If they don't, even though they're 4-0 and they look like the best team in the Big Ten, they want to get a shot to play. And look, Ohio State is good this year. They have a lot of good players. Justin Fields, a quarterback. Are they as good as last year's team? I think if you put true serum into every Ohio State fan, they tell you not as good as last year, but still really, really good. Still national championship level competitor. But when it comes down to it, you got to play more than 4 or 5 games. Yeah, it's not fair to the other Power 5 leagues who went forward, had a plan together, and made things happen. It's not fair to Bama. It's not fair to to Clemson, Notre Dame, all these teams just said, we're going to play football. We're going to make it happen. So with that being said, I mean, even the American Conference to some extent, yeah, they said, we're going to play football. So it's just, how do you judge a team, a full body of work, when you have such a small sample size? And Ohio State looked like they were going to dominate Indiana, but then they came back in and almost made it a game. I don't think if you're the Big Ten, you want Indiana versus Northwestern or Wisconsin in your Big Ten title game if it happens. The Big Ten is almost canceling each other out at that point. That's what it looks like from the outside looking in. And if you're an Ohio State fan, look, I sympathize with you guys. It sucks. And we'll find out on Tuesday, for the time being, mind you, on Tuesday, if Ohio State is still up there, highly ranked, in the top four, things will be okay for the moment. And I think people will breathe a slight sigh of relief. But I don't know if they'll be able to hold on to that if they don't play this week. This coming Saturday. They don't play Michigan. They don't play the Big Ten Championship game. I think this Tuesday, you know, don't want to send mixed signals if you're the committee. I really hope the committee is open and honest that, listen, for now, Ohio State will be in the top four. But if they don't play some of these games, yes, it's Michigan State, Michigan. They're both really bad this year. But Michigan State, they did beat Northwestern. For whatever that's worth, if you thought Northwestern was good this year, their defense is okay, their offense, eh. It's just something to think about. Big Ten screwed over most of their teams. Nebraska really wanted to play. They probably shouldn't have because, man. And Nebraska's coming to Norman next year. Oh, God. For historic reasons and for nostalgic reasons, I'm looking forward to OU playing Nebraska next year, but ooh, it's going to be ugly. Ooh, they come Norman. If most of OU's team comes back next year and Nebraska comes, ooh, it's going to be ugly. It's going to be 1996, 97 ugly, except it'll be flipped this time, OU over Nebraska. It can be 70 points. It can be really bad. Yeah, those are my thoughts. I just take away names, hash ranks. You can't put a team in there with like four or five games. You just can't do it. It's just not fair to the teams who've actually played this year. And so where does that leave? Like, who do you put in there in that situation? We can have the Cincinnati talk with a one-loss A&M who did not look good. You could try to spin it all you want. A&M looked like crap. Like, beating a mediocre LSU team, you know, barely beating them. I know the score was 20-7, but most of that game, it set football back like 50 years. It was not fun to watch. So, those are my thoughts on that. We'll see what happens Tuesday with the rankings. OU will stay roughly the same. Might move down a spot. Someone might move ahead of them for whatever reason. But, because some teams won, like Iowa State won, so they might bump Iowa State above us just like, oh, we made a mistake, you actually beat OU, ha ha ha. But as of right now, OU Baylor on Saturday, no time for West Virginia yet, so we'll obviously not next week. But getting through these games is key, OU dominating is key. If they want to make that push that, hey, you know, we're a much different team late in the year, we're really good, we have a pass rush, we have a defensive line. It's pretty good. Give us a shot. September was a long time ago. But yeah, light up your comments hating on me, saying I'm wrong, saying I'm terrible. I've been loving them this week. They've been a lot of fun. Boomer Sooner, y'all have a good one. And new 5 stars tomorrow on Rivals, so check that out. Later.